What would happen if a Buddhist monk falls in love and lets his sexual desires control him? Hi guys, welcome to Plot Recap. Today, we will recap the events of a Korean drama romance movie from 2003, Spring, Summer, Fall, Winter, and Spring. Let's start. The movie starts with an overview of a place in South Korea. A Buddhist monastery is situated in the middle of a beautiful pond, and the only way to access it is through a boat. And even though there are no walls, the pond is only accessed by two big doors. The season is spring, and we see the doors to the pond opening. Now we get to see inside the monastery, where an old monk is praying in front of a Buddha statue. He completes his prayer and wakes up his disciple from sleep. The young disciple wakes up and directly goes to the praying area. He completes his prayer and goes outside. There, the old monk and the disciple get in the boat and leave. The monk goes to beg for food in the village, whereas the disciple goes to collect herbs from the forest. While collecting herbs, the disciple reaches a big Buddha statue and takes a look at the scenery. He only sees their monastery in the pond, so he leaves. The two of them meet at the big door and get in the boat. They reach the monastery, where the monk helps the kid distinguish between edible and poisonous herbs. Here, the kid has a dog with him as a pet, and he plays with him all day before going to sleep. The next day, we can see the kid playing in a forest. There, he catches a fish and ties a stone around it. Then he releases it in the water and laughs as the fish is unable to swim. The old monk is watching him from a distance, but decides not to interfere. The kid then catches a frog and ties it with a stone too. He again laughs and enjoys as the frog is unable to move properly. He also finds a snake and tortures him in the same fashion. The old monk is watching him silently, but waits for the right opportunity. The monk decides to go back and takes a big stone with him. He reaches the monastery and finds the kid sleeping. He ties the big rock around the kid's back and waits for him to wake up. The kid soon wakes up and requests the monk to free him. But the monk says that he did the same torment to fish, frog, and the snake, so he deserves it too. He orders the kid to find and free all the three creatures. The kid obeys his master, and leaves in the boat with the stone tied to his back. He finds the fish, but it is already dead. So he buries it and cries. Then he finds the frog, and luckily, it's still alive. So he frees it and goes to find the snake. Unfortunately, the snake's also dead and he starts crying. Then the scene ends, and we see that summer has arrived. The doors to the pond open once again, and we see that the disciple has become an adult now. He goes to the mountains to collect some herbs, and there, he sees two snakes mating. He feels a tickling urge in his body, but he ignores it and moves on. Then, he sees two women coming towards the mountain. The two women are actually a mother and her daughter. The daughter is sick, so her mother has come to meet the old monk. The disciple greets the women and takes them to the monastery. In the monastery, the old monk explains to the mother that her daughter's soul is suffering. So once her daughter's soul finds peace, her body will become healthy too. The daughter stays in the monastery for treatment and the mother leaves. Then, we see that the disciple is starting to catch feelings for the girl. While the girl was changing her clothes, he accidentally opens the door and sees her without a shirt. He nervously closes the door and leaves. In the afternoon, he gets inside the monastery and sees the girl sleeping. He thinks that it's cold, so he decides to cover the girl with a blanket. Just then, he is unable to control himself and starts touching the girl's breast. The girl wakes up in disbelief and slaps him. The disciple realizes his mistake and starts apologizing to the Buddha statue. The scene ends there, and we see that the disciple now has a chicken as his pet. Time passes by, and one day, the disciple takes the girl out in the boat. He is so fascinated by her body that he keeps staring at her and even follows her in the forest. The girl is trying to catch a fish, so the disciple catches one and gives it to her. He again gets excited by her body, and starts touching her face. He slowly moves his hand towards the girl's breast, but the girl pushes him away, and leaves. The next day, the monk and his disciple can be seen preparing a drink for the girl. The disciple gives the drink to the girl and she drinks it. The treatment is working, and she is starting to feel better now. One day, the disciple is rowing the boat, and he sees that the girl is staring at him. He understands her signal, and takes her out in the boat. She happily goes with him, and the two can be finally seen making love. After having some fierce thrust game, they rest for a while on the mountain, and then go back to the monastery. After this experience, the disciple gets obsessed with the girl. At midnight, the old monk is asleep, and the girl invites the disciple to sleep with her. The disciple breaks the rule and goes straight to her without using the door. They start spending more and more time together, and the monk is completely unaware of it. One day, the two of them leave in the boat at midnight. And after having a good round of sex, they fall asleep in the boat. The next day, the old monk wakes up and finds his disciple sleeping naked with the girl. He opens the boat's hole, and the water starts flooding in. The disciple and the girl wake up, and somehow get to the monastery. Aware of his actions, the disciple starts apologizing to his master. But, the monk understands his actions, and tells him that it was natural that he went on this path. Then he asks the girl if she has recovered, and she says yes. The old monk says that she should leave now as she has no business here. He himself goes to drop her to the village. But just when they were about to leave, the disciple loses control, and asks the master to let her stay in the monastery. The master denies his request and explains that lust awakens the desire to possess, and that ultimately leads to misery. The monk goes to drop the girl at the village and comes back later. In the afternoon, the monk is sleeping, but the disciple is badly missing the girl. He packs up the Buddha statue in a bag, and decides to leave the monastery. He plans to meet the girl in the outside world. Here, the monk is actually awake, but decides to not stop his disciple from doing what he wants. The disciple leaves with his chicken in the boat. He releases the chicken in the forest and goes to find the girl. Time passes by, and we see that the autumn season has arrived. The old monk is still living alone, and has a cat as his pet. One day, he comes back from the village with the food he has begged. The food is wrapped in a newspaper, and when he was eating his food, an article in the newspaper catches his attention. The article is about a man who has fled after killing his wife who was cheating on him. The man in the newspaper is monk's disciple and the monk gets sad reading it. Next, the monk starts preparing clothes for his disciple as he knows that he will be returning anytime soon. The monk's prediction actually came true. The desire to possess made the disciple commit a murder. Then, we can see the disciple returning to the monastery. He has grown significantly and can be seen really angry and frustrated. The monk goes to pick him up in the boat. They come back to the monastery and the monk asks him about his life. He shouts that his only sin was to love and he killed his own wife as she cheated on him. Then, the disciple puts the Buddha statue back where it was when he took it. The next morning, the monk is sleeping peacefully, whereas the disciple is still angry and is unable to sleep. During the day, he attempts to commit suicide in front of the Buddha statue by holding his breath. But being the foolish being he is, he does not know that it's not possible to commit suicide in this fashion, and starts coughing. The monk overhears him coughing and opens the gate to check on him. He gets angry seeing his disciple attempting suicide and beats him with a stick. He further punishes him by tying him to a rope and hanging him. While the disciple is suffering, the old monk writes some mantras on the floor with his cat's tail. The disciple finishes the punishment, and cuts his hair with the same knife he used to kill his wife. He comes outside and sees a mantra written all across the monastery's floor. The old monk orders him to carve each letter of the mantra with knife. And says that his anger would slowly fade away with each letter carved. The disciple follows his orders and starts the work. But soon after, the pond's gate opens and we see two men calling for the old monk. The two men are actually police officers who are there to arrest the disciple. The monk goes to pick them up and brings them to the monastery. The police officers want to arrest the disciple, but the old monk asks them to let him finish the work. Respecting the old monk and the Buddhist culture, the policemen agree to wait until the next day. The disciple continues cutting the mantra and doesn't stop even when his hands start bleeding. He goes to cut through the entire night and sleeps only after finishing the work. The following morning, the old monk wakes up and starts filling the carvings out with colors. Even the policemen help the monk in filling colors. Then, the disciple wakes up, and as the old monk has said, his anger and frustration is completely gone now. He feels blissful and calm. Now, the disciple bows in front of his master, and leaves with the two policemen. The three of them get in the boat to leave, but it doesn't move. It only moves when the old monk waves his hand and says goodbye. Now that the monk's disciple is gone again, and for long this time, he gets sad and starts planning something. He places some wood in the boat and leaves his minimal belongings in the monastery. Then, he lights the wood on fire and sits on it, to end his life. This is actually a Buddhist ritual to end life on will, when you have achieved your purpose in life. While the wood is burning, we see that the old monk is actually crying. This indicates that even he, was unable to escape the pleasures of life. Then the monk's body gets engulfed by the flames and we see a snake passing near the boat. This is to signal that a new life cycle of the monk has started, and a soul never dies. Years pass and the gates to the pond open once again. The season is winter and we see that the disciple has returned after finishing his sentence. He goes inside the monastery and finds a snake sitting on his master's clothes. A snake represents rebirth in Buddhism. In an attempt to honor his master, he collects his master's ashes and places them inside a Buddha statue. The following day, he wakes up and creates a hole in the pond. He uses the pond's water to wash his face and goes to check his master's books. He resumes his training using the methods mentioned in the books and days pass by. One day, a woman with her face hidden and a crying baby in her hand show up at the pond gates. The disciple welcomes her and she prays in front of the Buddha statue. At the midnight, she leaves the baby in monastery and decides to run away. But while leaving, she accidentally steps on the hole the disciple had created. She falls in the water and dies on the spot. In the morning, the disciple wakes up and retrieves the woman's body. He blames himself for leaving the hole open, and following his master's principles, decides to punish himself. He ties a heavy stone around his waist and takes a Buddha statue with him. He starts his journey towards the mountain, and realizes how the fish, frog, and snake must have felt. After hours of climbing, he reaches the mountain's top and places the statue there. He meditates there for a while, and takes a look at the beautiful view. And this time, instead of just seeing the monastery, he is able to see much far away, indicating that his vision in life has grown exponentially. In the end, we see the doors to the pond open once again in the spring season. Now the disciple has become the master, and the baby that women left is his disciple. This time, they have a turtle as their pet, and the kid plays with it too. The kid disciple is exactly like his master. He too can be seen torturing a fish, frog, and snake, just like his master did. This indicates that a human's fate is decided, and he will always suffer before finding the right path. That was it for the recap, guys. This movie has numerous scenes that have a deep meaning. In the beginning of the movie, they had fish as their pet, which represented freedom. Then they had a dog which represented the disciple's obedience towards his master. And when the kid became young, they had a rooster that represented his desire to chase pleasures. Then a cat which represented the need to adopt pinpoint focus for achieving self-realization. And lastly, a turtle that represented longevity and calmness. You can find many more meanings in the movie if you observe carefully. See you guys in the next video.